This month's mainsail sees us as guests of the Royal Yacht Squadron on Great Britain's sailing heartland, the Isle of Wight. It's an iconic yacht club that this week is running a regatta to celebrate 200 years of existence. Unpredictable summer winds in the Solent, the body of water that provides the squadron with its world-famous racing arena, meant day one here had to be cancelled. But day two is looking much more hopeful. And so the course setters get to work planning where the races will take place, using well-established, tried and trusted methods.
This system has stood the test of time. The system, to my knowledge, that board behind me has been here since at least 1978. I think it's the first time I saw it. It works, is the short answer. The reason we use bits of string is to make sure that we don't conflict ourselves. It's very easy to forget if you don't have a visual reference where you've sent somebody, and you end up with, you could potentially end up with a very dangerous situation.
For the platform race officers, there are many difficult decisions to be made.
The main thing is to keep calm during this thing, because you're being bombarded from all sides. The thing is to remember what it's like when sailing and think about what it's going to be like if you were in the boat.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You know, I've raced off a squadron line a lot, and I've always looked up and I've seen the, you know, the white caps and the blazers, and just thought, I don't know, it was all very stuffy. But it's actually a very efficient organisation. It's run with routine, it's run with precision, there's a lot of decision making. Everything is ever changing, and it's quite active. There's a great buzz here. It's quite a privilege to see it.
How many boats are we expecting in class one?
7. 10.
It is a great relief to see the first boat cross the line and disappear as that one is. Brilliant. We now have a regatta and we're all much more relieved.
And there's such a variety of yachts here. It's like the J's and the classics, you know. That it's not easy, is it, to accommodate all that?
We're going to find out today.
I don't think I'll be around for the next one.
Oh, Peter, come on. Don't be so pessimistic. No.
Relief on the platform as the members get their week of celebration underway. This week we'll see some of the most recognisable yachts in the world compete side by side. Classics such as Marikita and Dorade will take to the waters alongside the state-of-the-art Rambler, who's making her UK debut. Three spectacular J-class boats are racing with some of the top guns of the modern sailing world.
20 people on the platform.
With the members busy on the platform, Chief Steward James is keeping on top of this week's workload.
Up in the pavilion, or even the bar staff.
I started off in 1989, and I started off as a gopher, which is go for this, James, go for that. I became Chief Steward in 2007. It's a tough job, but you need to be calm, you need to be patient. You've got to be willing to work long hours.
Morning, James.
Good morning, sir. I would say it's the most fantastic club in the world. We've got some of the loveliest members. In their lives outside of the castle, they run big companies. But here, they're here on holiday. They're here for their friends, they're here for the food, and more importantly, they're here for the sailing.
Whilst James is looking after the members inside, out on the water, the classic yachts are racing on an unforgiving Solent. It is a tough but rewarding day, with early gusts up to 30 knots on this 22-mile course.
It was quite something out there today. I mean, we had been warned about what the conditions would be like, and the Solent lived up to its reputation, I think, today.
Matt Brooks and Pamrock Levy are here representing the St. Francis Yacht Club in San Francisco with their 52-foot classic, Dorade. Launched in 1930, Dorade changed the offshore racing game with its innovative design, winning more ocean races than any other yacht of its time, including the Fastnet race in 1932. An invitation to this event was irresistible.
This is such a sort of iconic yacht club, and I think people wonder about it all over the world because it is small, it's very exclusive, There's a sense that it's a very elite group of people and an elite group of sailors who belong to it. And the opportunity to come here and see it, be able to go inside, be able to meet the members, be able to sail right out in front of the club, I mean, who would want to miss that?
It's quite an honor and quite a unique experience. You know, it only happens once every 200 years.
Day 3 of the bicentenary, and the fleet will take on one of the most iconic race courses in sailing, a race around the Isle of Wight. It was this race, a clockwise navigation of the 60 miles around the island, that saw the schooner America first win what has since become the oldest trophy in world sport, the America's Cup.
And we're sailing that very same course today, 60 miles clockwise around the island, and we're doing it on this beautiful schooner, Eleonora.
She may look old, but Eleonora, the largest yacht in the fleet, was built in 2000 and is an exact replica of the schooner Westward, an American racing yacht that in the early 1900s was the fastest boat on the planet.
Bicentenary International Yachts, this is Castle One. Stand by for countdown.
Not too much, Smittick, not too much,
Smittick. 30 seconds.
Well, we're just moments from the start. It feels a little bit surreal. Yesterday we were on the platform watching the members start the racing, but today, well, we're actually sailing. We're trying to work out how to get the best start off the squadron line.
5, 4, 3, 2.
He's the main, Biggie.
Fairway.
And that's it. We're off. Eleonora is a replica of a boat that won many races. She was state of the art 100 years ago. And I'm just watching Rambler and Jetty powering past us, the modern equivalent. We've been sailing upwind for quite a long time around the back of the island, and we're just about to go around the most western point of the Isle of Wight, the Needles, and then head down into the flat water of the Solent and the squadron finish line. And for me, I mean, this is the favourite bit. I love this bit. Downwind, the spinnaker's up, racing to the finish, just as they would have done all those years ago.
And while we turn for home around the Needles, the planning for the celebrations off the water is gaining pace at another Isle of Wight landmark. At Osborne House, Queen Victoria's summer residence, Caroline Peel has the daunting task of organising the finale of the whole bicentenary week for 1,200 guests.
I think we've been working on it over 2 years. The regatta's been about 4 years in sort of planning and birth, really. An elephant has a shorter gestation than this.
Here we are, 13.
There's a lot to do, but Caroline is maintaining a brave face.
I've always been renowned for having a big smile, even when I sink sailing. So you can, you know, it's a way of covering up one's nerves, I think. But I am nervous, and I hope it's going to be all right.
So racing and party planning are going well, and midway through the week, there are smiles all round.